There's no let-up in the Football League. They played for points at the weekend. Now it's the turn of the Carling Cup and a massive opportunity for someone to make their mark in the first week of the season. McAllister won this competition as a player with Liverpool in 2001, and 5 years before that he captained Leeds in the final. As a manager, his only ambition this season is to get Leeds promoted, but he knows the value of a good cup run and he brings a strong team to the Diva Stadium. Chester City finished 90th in the country last season, 5 points off relegation, and on Saturday they started off with a devastating 6-0 defeat at Dagenham. Hardly the credentials for taking on Leeds, but this is their chance tonight to grab a slice of glory by taking a big, big scalp. We're live in the first round of the Carling Cup at the Diva Stadium. It's Chester City against Leeds United, live on Sky Sports 2 and HD2. That's channel 409. 6 months ago, Tottenham lifted the Carling Cup. This is where the road to Wembley begins again, and a marvellous chance for lower league clubs to leave a mark on the competition. One man has left a huge imprint on the League Cup. Ian Rush began his career at Chester and collected 5 winners' medals with Liverpool. He jointly holds the goal-scoring record of 49 with Jeff Hurst, and he also played for Leeds United. It's really good to see Ian here tonight. Good to see you. What do you make of Leeds United in the competition this season, Ian? You know, they've obviously got promotion on their mind, but Gary McAllister says, listen, I'm picking the strongest team possible because I want to get into a good rhythm early season. Is that good policy?
Yeah, very much so. I think Gary McAllister, he's a winner, and it doesn't matter what competition you play in, you want to win. And I think it's important after the defeat in the playoff final last season. It could be a bit difficult, but they've started the season off with a good win and you want to carry that on. And I think that's why he's playing the strongest team tonight, because now they want to win this game and they want to win it in 90 minutes.
A lot of clubs around the country tonight will be changing their squad dramatically, won't they? But he's not. Is there any risk in that at all?
No, there's no risk because he believes in his players. And no, if you're winning games, you want to play games. And I say, because Gary's been a player himself, and they've also got, you know, Steve Staunton there as well, they want to be playing week in and week out. And basically, they'd rather be playing than training. So I think Gary knows what he's doing.
It was sad for Chester last season, wasn't it? A club you know very, very well. It's in your heart, I'm sure, still Chester. Yeah. And that was poor last season. A poor start this season as well.
Yeah, I think the first game of the season, you go into the game with optimism, thinking, you know, we're going to start really well. And to lose the first game 6-0 can be a bit demoralising sometimes. But this is a game for Chester now. They've got a couple of players back. It's a chance for Chester to say, listen, let's dig in, dig deep. And you never know. That's what the Cup's all about, you know, where lower teams beating the top ones. And if they can get a result here, they'll get them back going again.
Yeah, while Leeds United were winning at Scunthorpe on Saturday, Chester were losing 6-0 at Dagenham and Redbridge. They'd lost 6-2 there back in February. It really was a bad performance by Chester, but a good chance now for Simon Davis and his squad to put that right. It'll be hard, but he knows he has to lift his squad. He's with Andy Burton now.
Simon, how on earth do you try and pick your players up from a defeat such as you had at the weekend? And is a game so quickly the perfect opportunity to try and set that right?
Yeah, it would have been a bit harder if we had a Saturday game, you know, with the week to try and, you know, lift them. I think the best thing to do is, you know, get back out there, especially an attractive title tonight with you guys here and, you know, all the support here tonight. Then, if they can't do it on a stage like this, then we are going to struggle.
What have you said to your players to go out and correct this?
Just actually show everybody else what they've been showing me in training and pre-season, and it was a shocking performance really by everybody, and it was just disappointing. And you know, luckily it's only one game, it's only 3 points dropped, and we I don't want to make too much of a deal of it, but there was a lot of individual errors out there, which is difficult from a coaching angle if you like, but No, we're looking forward to tonight and we're hoping to put Saturday's performance to bed tonight.
And if you do put that to bed, how confident are you that you can cause an upset here?
Yeah, I mean, there's a division above us. I know they're, you know, such a big club and a lot's expected of them this season. But saying that, you know, 11v11 out there and we've got some quality in our team. Didn't show at the weekend, it's time to go and show it tonight.
Thanks a lot, good luck.
Thank you.
Big game for Paul Butler tonight, former Leeds United player, of course, and 35 years old now, but a big influence, Ian, on the Chester team. He lost his centre-back partner, Paul Linwood, on Saturday in the warm-up, yeah, which is one of the problems they had on Saturday, but Paul's back tonight. But how important is Paul Butler to the team?
He's very important. I think he's got height in the side. I think you look at the goals he let in on Saturday, a lot of them were some set plays. And I think with Linwood and Paul Butler there, they'll try and steady the ship. And that's what it's all about. I think they played 4-3-3 on Saturday and didn't go quite well. So I think the most important thing is now that you don't give Leeds a sniff early on. And when you've got Butler there and Linwood there, I think they'll be trying to do that.
Got Jermaine Beckford up for Leeds, you know, really, really quick. Is that a problem for the likes of Paul Butler? His legs won't be as quick as they were.
It will be a problem because he's on form as well. But it's, you've got to use your head when you're playing against people with pace and all that, and that's what the experience is all about. And if you can keep Beckford quiet, I think you've got a chance of getting the results anyway, and that's what it's all about, you know, keeping the star opposition quiet.
Well, Gary McAllister's aim this season is promotion, but he wants a good cup run and he's brought a strong team. Just two changes tonight from Saturday. He's with Andy Burton now.
Gary, how much attention have you paid to the scoreline from your opponent's game at the weekend?
Well, the facts were it surprised us, you know, but we come here expecting a reaction from the Chester players, you know. Any player that suffers that sort of defeat is going to hit their pride, you know, so we're expecting a tough match against Chester tonight off the rebound of that result.
You've spoken to your opposite number, Simon Davies, tonight before the game, I know. Does he seem like a broken man or is he OK? Is he coping?
No, not at all. It's one game in. He's very surprised with the result. You know, he lost his captain in the warm-up, had to make a few changes, so that hit him hard. He had a couple of young, inexperienced players having to cope out of position. So it was a bit of a freak result, I think.
What are Leeds fans coming here to watch the game tonight? Does that put a bit of extra pressure on you at all?
There's always pressure at Leeds United. You know, we come here, you know, we're the favourites. We're expected to win. But hopefully we can live with that. You know, we're taking this very serious. We want to progress in the Carling Cup. And we'll feel he's a strong side. You know, there's a debut for Luciano Becchio, who we brought in from Spain. And young Fabian Delph will play as well tonight.
And I guess you want to get this wrapped up pretty quickly. A quick start, high tempo, is that right?
Yeah, we want to play it. We're a division above, you know, so we want to play it. You know, we want us to dictate the pace of the game. You know, and hopefully that'll prove difficult for Chester.
Good luck, Gary. Thanks.
Thank you.
You know, the moment Gary McAllister came into Leeds United last season, and he said, we're playing football. Don't care what went before, we're playing football. And he's got two wide men in this season, hasn't he, to make it even easier on the eye, if you like.
Yeah, you look at Leeds and they seem to play their 4-4-2, and I think that's what he played when he was at Leeds and also when he's at Liverpool, and he liked playing that system. And I think it's important when you've got the wide men, you've got like Robinson and Snodgrass, their deliveries have been fantastic. And for a striker, when you see them deliveries coming in, that's all you want. You're going to get chances with the quality of these deliveries, and that's all about playing football. They're not just going to throw a ball in, they're going to play football and get it in. You need the football brain to know when to put them deliveries in.
There's no distractions this year for Leeds in terms of all the hoopla going around the 15 points. Mm. But Gary said he still wants a kind of siege mentality. Why is that?
I think what you're looking at is look at the start of the season they had last season. They had a fantastic start of the season, and you've got to be looking to do the same. I would imagine the pre-season would be similar to what they've done because they had a good start of the season. And it's all about winning games. It's a mental strength and mental toughness. If you're winning games, you feel confident and you go out there, you're never tired. But when you're losing games, you seem to get tired. And it's all in the head, and I think that's what Gary's looking for, to get out there, get a good winning mentality, and that'll take the club forward.
And so, if they were to lose against a struggling Chester team, confidence goes out the window early on, doesn't it?
Yeah, very much so. I think that's what it's all about. I think the cup is about shocks. It is at Chester, so there is a chance that they can do it. But if they lose tonight, they'll be very, very disappointed.
Leeds always take a big support anywhere, don't they? They'll be right behind them tonight.
Yeah, that's one thing about it. You know, Leeds, there's always a sellout wherever they go. They are great away support as well. That's one thing about them. It'd be a bit like an home game for them because they are very vocal with the support. But saying that, you know, Chester have got to get the supporters have got to get behind them play as well to make it a good, entertaining game.
If you go back to how they've played each other over the years, they've met five times, where four of those have been in the League Cup. And of course, one famously back in 1974 when they beat the league champions, Leeds United, 3-0 and went off to the semi-finals that year. I'm not sure that can happen again.
Well, I don't think it will, but I was actually at that game as a kid watching that, and it was an unbelievable result. There was 18, 19,000 at the game then. It was absolutely incredible, it was. But I think Chester will be happy with 1-0 tonight.
Memories going back a few years there. OK, this is tonight. This is the Carling Cup first round. And the commentators are Gary Birtles and Rob Hawthorne.
But for the fact that three teams in League Two are on minus points, Chester would be bottom of the Football League now after Saturday's 6-0 hammering at Dagenham. Skipper Paul Linwood, who was injured in the warm-up, has recovered to play tonight. But apart from Linwood's return, there's just one other personnel change, with one former Accrington midfielder replacing another, David Mannix preferred to Jay Harris. Mannix, Anthony Barry and Frenchman Damien Mazika are making home debuts. There's no question of Leeds taking this lightly. Gary McAllister makes two changes from the opening day win at Scunthorpe. One enforced, with David Prutton carrying a slight injury, so 17-year-old Fabian Delph comes in. Up front, McAllister gives a first start to Argentine Luciano Becchio. Each team has seven substitutes to choose from, but no goalkeeper in Chester's case. There's a real contrast on the Leeds bench with 36-year-old Paul Telfer, just signed on a non-contract basis, and 17-year-old striker Tom Elliott, who made his debut for the club while still at school. So, Gary Birtles, is this the perfect fixture for Chester to pick themselves up?
It's got to be. If you can't raise yourself for a game like this against Leeds United, then you shouldn't be playing the game. They'll be desperate to be put Saturday's result right, but Leeds United look very strong. They've got the full strength out, just a couple of niggling injury problems with Prutton and people like that, but Leeds have got to be massive favourites.
Well, they may have fallen on hard times recently, Leeds, and be in League One, but they are still a big name in English football. They are a scalp worth claiming, and Chester, despite the weekend's humiliation, hoping they can do it at Diva Stadium tonight. Chester against Leeds, coming live next.
Cup is underway tonight. We're starting off at the Diva Stadium. Chester against Leeds. Commentators Gary Birtles and Rob Hawthorne.
Getting a first look in this competition at Luciano Becchio, his first start for Leeds. He scored prolifically in the lower leagues in Spain. He's a young Argentine player, 24 years of age, and Gary McAllister giving him his first start tonight, up against a former Leeds United captain. Paul Butler played over 100 games for the club, including their championship playoff final defeat against Watford. Now at the age of 35, he's hoping to hold together a Chester defence that was ripped apart in their opening league game at the weekend. Storm clouds in the air, with lightning heading towards this stadium, and storm clouds gathering at the moment over Simon Davis, who's only recorded one win since he succeeded Bobby Williamson as manager back in March. That was in March against Darlington. Gary McAllister in discussions there with his coach Neil McDonald, and he'll be taking absolutely nothing for granted. And that is why he has shown Chester the respect he has with the team that he's playing tonight. Even though there may be a storm on the way, we're in the last stages of sunshine here, which seem to be right into the Leeds manager's eyes. It's the second meeting of these two at this stage of the competition in the matter of 3 years. In their relegation year from the Championship, Leeds beat Chester 1-0 at Elland Road with a second half goal from Eric Backer. Leeds United, one of 10 former winners of the competition, with their necks on the block in the first round of this season's Carling Cup. And they get the game underway with Huntington finding the left-back, Alan Sheehan. Sheehan looking to switch it out wide to Snodgrass, but it's a little behind the man, brought in from Scotland with Livingston, where he got to the semi-finals of the League Cup competition north of the border back in 2006. Thing that Chester will need after that weekend defeat is to concede an early goal. It was the second time they conceded six at Dagenham in the matter of 6 months. They lost 6-2 there last season.
best of starts, without a doubt, but you can see the way they've set up with Masika and Mannix. Two midfielders protecting the back four. I think just a bit of insurance for them. Keep it tight early on, don't give anything away.
It's about Ankergren, who conceded first for Leeds at the weekend, but they recovered to win at Glanford Park. Here's Paul Huntington. And now Rui Marquez. Looking long for Beckford. He's already got his first goal of this season. The header clear was by Butler. That's a foul on the back of Ryan Lowe by Rui Marquez. He made his debut for Leeds in this competition. It was a nervy debut as well at right back against Oldham some 3 years ago. He didn't play another game that season. And the Leeds defenders looking right into the sun.
Chester's got to do early on. He's just be patient. What they're going to do is close Leeds down. Don't give it any time, any space. Don't be too worried about not being too offensive. Just settle down, get the nerves on an even keel and just deny them space and time and then start coming into your own.
Clearance there by Fraser Richardson, who's been appointed as Leeds captain for this season. He is the club's longest serving player now. Seventh season as a senior professional. And from his throw-in he finds Huntington, who did wear the captain's armband pre-season. As Gary McAllister was still making up his mind on who to give the armband to permanently. Side flag is up here against Ryan Lowe. Lowe, who's now in his second spell here, having been brought back from Crewe. He got a couple of goals two seasons ago when Chester put Nottingham Forest out of the FA Cup, and it's that sort of result perhaps that they'll be looking for tonight against another big team that's fallen into League One. Kick there looking for Beckford, who got on the end of it, and it's a shocking start for Chester, who are a goal down inside 3 minutes, and it's the ever-prolific Beckford, he's got it.
Well, it's a goalkeeper, gets the assist, Ankergren, they're going to him. It's just a long, hopeful ball from the goalkeeper. Should have been dealt with, wasn't. And that's what plagued them on the first game of the season. And you know that man is going to be poaching in this area. Long, straight punt. They don't deal with it, but it's still a great finish. They should have dealt with that. Keeper didn't come, stayed on his line. And look at that, just got half a yard. Past Butler, lovely toe end. Still had a lot to do when it came to him. It's a fine finish.
Seventh goal that Chester have conceded already this season, and the second goal that Jermaine Beckford has scored in this campaign. Leeds top scorer last season with 20. Got one against Scunthorpe at the weekend. He's got another here. Worst possible start for Simon Davis.
That'll annoy him, the way the goal came. Just a long punt by the goalkeeper. Nobody won it in the air. Let it bounce to Beckford, just a stretched out boot, and it is a really good finish because he could have hoisted it over the bar, tried to put too much on it. He didn't, just caressed it in.
And it is the Leeds defenders who are looking into the sun, but it was the Chester defence who failed to cut out that long ball downfield from Ankergren. Offside flag up there against Lowe.
It's not bad from Lowe, that's twice within the last minute or so, just before Leeds scored. He nearly got it on the right-hand side, trying to play the ball down that channel for him. He's just been a little bit offside, half a yard both times. Can we have run a little bit better against the centre half, he might have a chance.
Another foul by Marquez into the back of Lowe. Really was the worst possible blow to deal to Chester that. They've just been building their confidence with one or two little moves. Lowe has been getting into some decent positions. Shattering start for them, conceding to Beckford already. Mannix looking to win it, run back by Howson. That's Snodgrass, and now Becchio finds Richardson, cut out though by Ellison.
We saw there, you've got to be precise with your passing. The grass looks a little bit long, holding the ball up a wee bit. And Simon Davis, he would have said, right, it was a magnificent piece of individual ability that cost us a goal. Yeah, we've been done by it, but to lose a goal in that manner just depresses you so much.
There's Becchio looking for Beckford, just beyond his reach this time. It was a straightforward bit of poaching, really, from Beckford that led to the goal. Gambling on the ball, running past Paul Butler, which he did. And then showing that unerring ability of his to steer the ball into the net.
Master poacher there. Saw a goal from a similar master poacher at Birmingham on Saturday. but one chance, tremendous turn, and you're 1-0 winners in the last minute. There's Rui Marquez being put under pressure by Lowe. Well retrieved by Marquez. And here's Mazika, who was one of the few Chester players to emerge with credit from their defeat at Victoria Road at the weekend. One exempted from blame by his manager on his debut. Mazika, who was brought in from Nantes in France, although he had been on loan to a French third division team last season. Robinson came in with a tackle there. Here's Alan Sheehan. And Becchio is caught from behind by Butler. This kick goes short to Delph, and now here's Johnny Howson, whose goals got Leeds into the playoff final last season. And only for them to blow it in that game at Wembley against Doncaster. Here's Richardson. Looking to take on Wilson, he's got past him and somehow kept it in. Snodgrass really connect cleanly with the cross. That's Barry. Now Mazika. Back to him neatly by Lowe. Here's Ellison. Cleared by Richardson.
Doesn't look to have affected them too much, he thought it might do, but they're still trying to get it down, they're still trying to pass it. Play the way through the Leeds midfield. I'm sure Gary McAllister will want his team to do that. Get it down, one and two touch, move the ball, move the opposition around. Create space for Beckford and Becchio.
Here's Delph. Now Marquez. This is Howson. Looking for Richardson. Linwood letting it run out. John Danby, the Chester goalkeeper, one of three players in the team who played in that defeat by Leeds in this competition a couple of years ago. Lawrence Wilson and Paul Linwood in front of him also did. Robinson's boot was high, Chester free kick. Mannix leaving it for Butler to take. They switch it to Ellison. Richardson is staying tight to him. It's a foul.
Got to do here. He's got the big lads up from the back, sun in the goalkeeper's eyes, get it right in and around the penalty spot and just hope that they cause a problem for him.
Well, there are five around the edge of the area here for Chester if they can pick somebody out. They're looking to Linwood, but it doesn't reach him. Phased as he may have been by the sun, Ankergren saw enough of it to make a clean catch and to set Robinson away. And he's tried to set the youngster Delph away here. Snodgrass arrives and it's 2-0 inside 9 minutes. And Robert Snodgrass claims his first goal for Leeds.
So simple, so decisive. All came from a shocking free kick from Chester. Put the ball high and handsome right into Ankergren's hands. He distributed it superbly, very quickly. There he goes. Leeds on the counter-attack straight away. There's Robinson, sees it. Terrific run by Delph, who picks Snodgrass out, who's ran about 60, 70 yards, and again, timed it to perfection, the run. Terrific ball by the youngster. Again, didn't try and blast it. Just tries to keep it on target, keep it down, and does it superbly. Not a chance for Danby.
So the young Scotsman, who signed a three-year deal with Leeds back in July, has his first goal for his new club, and the problems mount for Chester. Both goals that have beaten their goalkeeper have started with the Leeds goalkeeper. Ankergren, whose kick set up the first for Jermaine Beckford, starting that Leeds move with a throw to Andy Robinson. Here's Partridge looking for Ellison as Chester looks somehow for a foothold in what's already looking a desperate cause. Here's Partridge.
Well, they see the story. Two attempts, two goals. And you see the class, the difference in class. We've seen two classy goals, to be fair. I mean,
mean, they contributed to their own downfall with the first one, but the second one, they had a chance to put a bit of pressure on with the free kick. It was an awful one, straight into the goalkeeper's hands.
It's an even bigger crisis for Chester than it was at the weekend, when it took until just before half-time, 42 minutes, in fact, before they were 2-0 down. It was 2-0 at half-time, and here they're 2 down in the first 10 minutes.
One thing Gary McAllister will be delighted with the second goal especially, is the desire of his two midfield players, Delph in the first place and Snodgrass. They burst, must have been 60, 70 yards to get into the box, and they've got the just rewards.
Here's Rui Marquez. Now Huntington. And this is Sheehan. Richardson to Delph. Grass Van Housen will look for the return. Leeds fans already feeling comfortable and confident enough to cheer every pass.
Of course they will. What Leeds don't want to do is just settle for this now. They've got to be cruel. They can be. They're going to go and try and score more, put it beyond the reach. Chester get one back. We all know how important that can be.
McAllister's first involvement in this competition for a while, but when he was managing Coventry, he presided over an 8-0 win against Rushden & Diamonds. Header on there by Becchio. This is Beckford. It's Becchio. Snodgrass. By Linwood.
Really desire for Snodgrass, playing on the right hand side, pops up on the left hand side.
Robinson. Mazika. And a free kick quickly taken. Here's Robinson. Now Delph. This is Richardson. Now Snodgrass. You're beaten in the challenge by Lawrence Wilson. Zika goes down by Robinson, who gives away another free kick. Low, Partridge. Harry finding Wilson. Here's Partridge, who started on the right but has begun to float. Everything over to the left though at the moment. Here's Ellison. Ellison having to have a go, it deflected. And Epigren, bearing that in mind, did well to deal with it.
Indeed, it skidded off the surface. It's a little bit better from Chester. Good movement, good passing. Just need something to lift the home crowd a little bit. Simon Davies must have put two protective midfield players in front of the back four, but they could do nothing about the two goals. One's a route one, and the second one just comes from a free kick wasted by his own team.
Here's Mazika. Partridge. This is Lowe. Ryan Lowe again. It caught the Leeds defender, and Chester had a lifeline. Lowe will claim it, but the deflection looped it up into the net, and Chester strike back.
Well, Gary McAllister would have been pleased with what he's seen offensively, but defensively, I don't think he'll be that chuffed. A lot of space, a lot of time, and look, they just back off him. Just allow him to shoot. Yes, it takes a deflection, but you have to close down. He cuts inside, nobody's, three yellow shirts there, and look, Marquez just backs off, lets him have a shot, deflects off him and goes over the top. Poor defending on two occasions there in the build-up. Like we say, you don't kill it off, Chester get back in it, crowd suddenly becomes more active and lifts the players.
His first goal of the season and his first for Chester since his previous spell with the club back in February 2006. Against Stockport, with whom he had a loan spell last season. But here, Ryan Lowe has got Chester's first goal of this campaign, and all credit to them, because they could have capitulated, two down in 10 minutes, but now they've reduced that deficit by half.
Oh, Leeds react now.
Henderson. Foul by Rui Marquez, whose deflection carried the ball over Ankergren. So who knows, maybe there is a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow for Chester. By Huntington.
Well, decent build up there by Chester. Again, getting the crowd lifted. Somebody's got to take responsibility in the yellow shirt there and just calm it down now for Leeds.
And Simon Davis would have been a little fidgety, a little nervous at two down, and particularly with the manner in which he sided. Conceded those two goals, which had both stemmed from the Leeds goalkeeper, but the smile just starting to return now. Bit of hope.
It was nice to get your first goal of the season as a club, as a player. Yes, it had a hint of luck about it, but it was on target. Leeds have only got themselves to blame for loose defending.
Here's Richardson. Becchio. Fabian Delph. This is Alan Sheehan. Huntington. Nelson.
Suddenly the closing down becomes a lot better from Chester. I feel we've got a foothold in the game now. Wilson leads back, allowing them any space.
Here's Huntington. Now Rui Marquez. This is Richardson.
Set him up, let him
up. Jermaine Beckford, Linwood and Wilson there across with him. Beckford could make nothing of it. And there's Lowe. Now Ellison. Barry looking to get away.
Important thing for Chester with Lowe playing that lone role is that Partridge and Ellison do join in, and we saw Partridge for the goal do exactly that. Cut inside. Made the ball on for Lowe.
Huntington. Now Sheer. This is Marquez. Huntington. Option to play short, still having difficulty with their long-range passing from their own half with the Sun. Here's Mazika. It's low. At least a little early for Ellison, and he couldn't retrieve it. Here's Sheehan. James Vaughan has got a take on here. He's covered just behind though from Mannix. Partridge. Partridge striking it against Alan Sheehan. Son of Stephen Vaughan, the Chester owner and former chairman, although he stood down from that role back in December. Stephen Vaughan Jr. also still on the playing staff. He's among the Chester substitutes tonight. Here's Ryan Lowe. Partridge. Ball from Housen, right idea. Just couldn't find Beckford. Cut out by Linwood.
Taking no chances there, Linwood. It's a danger with Beckford. Just lurks on the shoulder of the centre-half, waiting for that mistake or one to fly over the top of them.
just settling into his role alongside Beckford. And here's Sheehan with a throw. It's Johnny Howson who can hit them.
Confident boy. It's going to be an absolute belter from there.
First involvement with the first team was that last League Cup tie between these two sides at Elland Road back in 2006. He was on the bench then for the team that he supported from... He was old enough to support a team. Here's Wilson with a kick. And Barry. Ellison. Snodgrass was looking for Beckford. James Vaughan has lost out there to Robinson. It's a good ball to Beckford. Cleared by Linwood. Beckford.
Disappointed with himself there. His first touch let him down, just took him away from goal a little bit. Again, they just committed a little bit of a problem for themselves there. Chester gave the ball away. Now Leeds to get in the final third.
Wilson. Now Lowe. That's Ellison. And the offside flag up against Anthony Barry. Making his home debut for the club tonight. He's back in home territory, having been born in Liverpool. But reached the playoff final in his time at Yeovil, with whom he lost both of his games against Leeds last season.
I think Chester will be that disappointed with the offsides they've had against them. It's been very close. Leeds play a higher line. And Chester do get it right and get beyond. It caused them a big problem.
There's Robinson.
15 or so minutes, Leeds were so slick, moved it quicker. Robinson and Snodgrass involved early on. They've got to start doing that again, get them wide. Keep switching the play, moving Chester around.
Here's Sheehan. Here's Marquez. Third. He's got another chance here. Real power took that past Andy, and it's 3-1.
It's an absolute cracker, but was he lucky there? His first touch wasn't particularly good. You watch it when it's played to him. Good ball by Marquez. There, goes away from him, and he's lucky to get it back. And it's a superb strike. Just gets it in that gap between goalkeeper and post. Perfect bend on it. Terrific technique. Not a lot Danby can do about it. But when you're on fire like he is, you get your little bits of luck. First touch went away from him, but he was lucky enough to get it back. When he was lucky enough to get it back, he punished Chester.
Plenty of power in that shot from Jermaine Beckford. Well, there's a man who could have plenty of power in his shots too, Peter Lorimer. He is part of the Leeds team that lost to Chester in this very competition back in 1975, when Chester went all the way to the semi-finals. 3-0, they were beaten at Chester's old ground. One from John James, one from Trevor Staunton. Leeds were defending league champions then, and 6 months later, seven of the team that started the defeat by Chester started the European Cup final.
I'll tell you what, Rob, He never wanted to stand in a defensive wall when Lorimer was taking the free kick. But he could hit a ball. Here's Linwood. And Mozica. Can Chester recover again? They held their nerve at 2-0 down. But now they've got to find another route through this Leeds defence. Robinson. Led by James Vaughan. Andy Robinson.
Impressed with Delph so far. He's very composed, very confident.
Delph now looking for Becchio. Linwood up. Delph is up against Becchio. There's Lowe. Cut out by Richardson. Huntington. Now need another lifeline. If Linwood they're looking to there. Good's initial loose touch came back off Linwood before he delivered that hammer blow to Chester. Plenty of delight amongst the 1,400 or so Leeds fans though. He came out on top of a most hated club survey in the English League last week, Leeds United, but I think they are of that mentality, aren't they, that no one likes us but we don't care. Here's Beckford having a go from long range. Certainly the siege mentality served them well last year when they had that huge points deficit to overcome, and Gary McAllister was looking to retain that without having the disadvantage of the deficit this time around.
He's having a little giggle at Beckford's attempt there. I think that's just at your car in the car park, Rob. Sorry for Chester. Yes, they gave the first two goals away. The third one was a bit fortunate. They've had a few bright spots of play in and around the 18-yard box, and Leeds look a little bit shaky, as with the goal. Been offside a couple of times just by half a yard or so, and they're still trying to probe forward.
Well, the lifeline his team had given themselves has now been snatched away by that second strike from Jermaine Beckford, who will be looking now for his first senior hat-trick at Snodgrass. Now Delph. Robinson. Well, Robinson making the point that he played that ball through to Becchio and there was an advantage there to be played. Graham Salisbury disagrees.
And is he feeling sorry for them?
And the referee has pulled out a card. Huntington's free kick. Away by Butler. Now Barry. Snodgrass. Here's Beckford. And Snodgrass has got one already. Slips in Robinson for number four.
No, nothing lucky about that. That's clinical. That's how Gary McAllister loves his teams to play.
late in the feet, move. And that's exactly where that goal came from. But again, Chester gave the ball away and allowed Leeds back in there and give the ball away. And the next minute to the back of the net. There's one pass. A little reverse pass there. Good awareness. And look at this flipping. He knew exactly what he was doing, Robinson. Beckford, lovely little ball, weighted to perfection. And again by Snodgrass. And what a finish. All from giving the ball away again. But give Leeds the credit they deserve for creating what they did in the end.
Well, back close to home territory, Andy Robinson. Birkenhead-born. Played for non-league Camel Laird and was released by Tranmere without ever really being given an opportunity. But celebrates his first goal for Leeds, and Leeds in a commanding position. And really, this margin could be any number now in view of Chester's fragile confidence.
The thing is, Rob, they said they committed a lot of defensive errors on Saturday. Again, they've done it now. You can't give the ball away like they did to Leeds, not expect to get punished. We see six attempts for Leeds United and four have gone in. Four on target, four goals, doesn't get better.
There's Marquez. Now Robinson. Is Delph. Wilson with the back header. The League Cup has already featured some heavy defeats for Chester in recent times. The last 25 years they've let in five against Villa and Arsenal, six against Nottingham Forest, seven at Coventry. But their heaviest loss in it was a third round tie against Leyton Orient some 46 years ago, and they lost 9-2. Delph. Shear. Could be a long night for Chester this. Beckford in looking for his hat-trick. Away though by Butler. Showed too much of it to the defender.
Well, if I'd have been Becky out there, I'd have been slaughtering Beckford. He was in acres of space. And he's after that hat-trick already. Be patient, it'll come. Help your teammate out.
Well, Linwood committed and Snodgrass has tried to play Beckford in for his hat-trick. And what a way to claim it! A brilliantly executed hat-trick, the first of his senior career. That is magnificent!
Couldn't have put it better myself. I said be patient and it'll come. He was patient for about 10 seconds and it came. Absolutely fantastic. I thought he was going to play Becky Owen again, but no. When your confidence is this high, he's gone in for the tackle there, but look how quickly he gets up. Becchio in a good position, would have been easier to do that, but look at that for total confidence. Thought he might put it across, but that is a difficult technique. The ball's moving, he's just got to get his foot tucked under it a little bit and do that. That is absolutely majestic. Three terrific goals, three different goals. You can see why they want to hold on to him. People will say, well, it was only against Chester, they're having a bad time, but you've still got to finish as he's finished.
Here's Ellison. And now Delph. Well, it's the Jermaine Beckford show so far. A 35-minute hat-trick. A brilliant hat-trick as well.
McAllister would be delighted with the performance of Delph. Really impressed with it.
Well, look at that. Three on target, three goals.
hard, is it, though? But he is a really confident guy, and you can see that in the goals he scored. First one, hanging in the air a long time, was toe-poked it in. Second one, saw the gap between the goalkeeper and post. Power, direction, and the third one was total class.
Back on his feet, having been caught by Butler there. Jermaine Beckford, who started last season really well, got six in the first seven league games. The goals really just dried up for him at the wrong time towards the back end of the campaign, but he's very much back on song now.
This is how important it is to put a good strong side out in a game like this. Gary McAllister's done this. I remember playing for Forest many years ago in the same competition, and Oxford were in the league, and it was the first game for us, and we went away and won 5-0. And as a striker, when you're scoring in games like that, your confidence rises. And that'd be the same with Beckford, and you just hope now that Becchio could get one just to get his campaign up and running.
There's six conceded at Dagenham at the weekend for Chester. It could be six before half-time here. Leeds still with another 8 minutes to try and add to Chester's humiliation. That can't enter their considerations at all. They've mercilessly exposed the weaknesses in this Chester side so far. It's Wilson's free kick. Linwood trying to make of it what he could.
Can be brutal in this game.
Well, the second goal started with Ankergren, and Robinson very nearly got away from Mosica again there. He set Sheard away. Delf, a bit heavy for Becchio, and he can't keep it in.
Yeah, disappointing from Delf. It's the first time he's given the ball away.
More Carling Cup action to come tomorrow on Sky Sports 2. Peter Taylor's Wickham in action against Birmingham, who started with that weekend win over Sheffield United. Sky Sports 2 and HD 2 from 7. Here it's a dream start to the competition for Leeds. 5-1 up, and we are not even at half-time. A hat-trick already for Jermaine Beckford.
That's not the mentality. When a side are down, I just used to love grinding them into the dirt if you possibly could, and that's the only way to go about it. The manager decides to rest a few, that's his decision, but while you're out there, make the opposition pay.
Try to play Ellison in here, and Richardson gets it away. Mannix. If it did, there was no intent on his part in the referee's view. No, he wasn't claiming too loudly. Mannix. Becchio going in to challenge Linwood, for whom it's been a really tortuous return to the first team in the way that this game has slipped away from Chester.
Question the desire from Chester. They're still trying to go about the business the same way. They're still trying to do the right things. The heads haven't totally dropped. It's a wonder they haven't, but... You know, team talk. What's that going to be like our time? Hope it's not a teacup throw, because that dressing room could be littered with crockery pieces.
Very much new to the management game, Simon Davis, and he couldn't have had it any... rougher. One win in 13 since taking over in March. Linwood, now Mozica. Shear. Mozica. Is Robinson. He's got one already. He's tried to claim Beckford, looking for his fourth. And the flag was up.
Well, Beckford has been given against him. He didn't think he was off. But again, they give the ball away there in the centre of midfield. Robinson pounces. In he plays Beckford, who's not offside. And when he plays it to him, slightly behind, he's not happy with that.
And the flag goes up before he plays it. And Beckford certainly didn't seem to be offside.
He wasn't offside.
Here's Sheehan. Robinson. Now Rui Marquez. Marquez. Now Mazika. Challenged by Robinson. It was a rather theatrical fall from Mazika, and the referee said the ball was won. Here's Sheehan. Interception by James Vaughan.
We'll see Beckford come off at half time. Now he's party piece.
Marquez. Now Snodgrass. Becchio. Partridge. And it's looking to pick out Kevin Ellison. Here's Sheehan. Delph. Leaned into it with his left arm. Free kick given. Here's Partridge. Take the throw in. Here's Barrett. Shadowed by Delph. Back by Sheehan. Through Marquez. Through the middle, but he's looked for Ellison instead. An ambitious ball cut out by Huntington.
Still taking no chances. No need to, don't be clever.
Partridge trying to weave a way through, and at least he's won Chester a corner. Can they grab themselves another consolation before half-time?
He's got a bit of a bright spot when he's had the ball at his feet, Partridge. And in the first goal. What a surprise, first corner of the game.
One added minute. Ellison's header.
You look at the scoreline, 5-1. You can't believe there's only one corner so far.
Beckford has been the main man for the goals.
Tonight, when he scores the quality of goals that he has, will there be bids appearing?
Will will be resisted, I'm sure, by Gary McAllister if they are. He is a vital part of their plan to get out of the division. Here's Beckford. Pulled out of the way by James Vaughan. A free kick here for Leeds, which could put the crowning glory on a first half display that has swept Chester aside. The first goal of the weekend stemmed from a free kick. There's the goal this time. John Danby, whose first goal conceded at the weekend was from a free kick.
He's been beaten by so much quality so far, though. Got a feel for him.
Snodgrass and Sheehan specialists in this situation, but Housen too is showing plenty of interest. And it's lined up for Robinson to curl one, and Danby holds on. The referee calls time as more misery is heaped on Simon Davis and Chester City by rampant Leeds and especially Jermaine Beckford. A hat-trick of exemplary finishing from him with the bonus of first goals for the club from Robinson and Snodgrass, making it Chester 1, Leeds 5.
Jermaine Beckford's first goals in the League Cup. He's only 46 behind Ian Rush now. We'll get Ian's views in a second. Chester have conceded 11 in 4 days. How many more will come in the second half? Will there be a declaration? Or live first-round Carling Cup action tomorrow. Before the game, we'll show you highlights from tonight. After that game, we'll show you the draw for the second round. It is Wickham versus Birmingham from 7 o'clock. Sky Sports 2 and HD 2. Tonight, Chester 1, Leeds United 5. There could be more to come. Depends how many Leeds want. And Chester playing for their pride now. Ian Rush, how pleased is Gary McAllister going to be in the dressing room?
I think he'd be very pleased. I think the way that they started the game off, 100%, they wanted to win the game, and I think he'd be very pleased at the moment.
Jermaine Beckford's going to score a few more hat-tricks probably in his career, but that's his first one. What's it like when you get your first hat-trick?
It's incredible. It's a great feeling. You know, you score them at all levels and all that, but to get one at your first top club level, it's something that you'll never forget. And the hat-trick he scored, there's three different goals as well. And for me, it was just quality. You look at the first one, just a long hole for ball, really, and he's got in behind Butler. You think, when the keeper, should he come out or not? But there's just his touch to that was absolutely fantastic. He used his strength to get in there, and all, he just stuck his foot out and went straight in the corner. Keeper had no chance.
Just 3 minutes, and you know from the 6-0 Chester suffered on Saturday, that's going to hit them hard, isn't it?
Yeah, I think after 6-0, you're thinking that first 10 or 15 minutes, keep it quiet, but... You know, Chester started to get back in the game, but this, I thought, went through the keeper's arms at first. But when you look at it from behind, you know, it was a bit of luck there by Beckford. It was actually left foot, and he's bent all the way round, and the keeper had no chance as well. So that was an absolutely fantastic finish.
And it hit the net hard as well. Good power.
Yeah, power. Peter Lorimer would have been proud of that.
Yeah, watching on. And perhaps the best one was, the last one of his hat-trick?
Yeah, very much so. I think
nice
you look at it.
Move.
Yeah, and because Leeds knew when to close down. They know what to do. And if there's a team in trouble, they'll close down, win the ball, and some movement again off the ball. And this was unbelievable because if you're looking at the other striker there, and I think you would have slaughtered him if he missed, because all he had to do was knock it to him. But when you score two goals, you're full of confidence, and that is a player playing full of confidence, and that's gone right in the top corner this time.
That's like the old Georgie West story about pass it to Dennis, pass it to Dennis. Oh, great goal, Georgie, because he had men on there, didn't he?
Yeah, typical. And what he should have done is just rolled in for his teammate. But, it's a quality goal. He tried to repay him later when the ball was offside and all that, but he's full of confidence.
It could be now embarrassing in the second half, couldn't it, unless Chester can really claw their way back into some pride.
Well, they're playing for pride and they're playing for the shirt as well. And there's supporters there who go there and they want to see, and I think it'd be interesting to see now what does happen, because you are playing for pride and it'd be a lot for the supporters, because Leeds, there could be more from Leeds' point of view, but I think what Chester got to do is, start over again as 0-0 and play for your pride.
Will Leeds want to make changes now?
If you were Beckford, you wouldn't want to come off. But as a manager, you'd think you want to try and save your best players for the game on Saturday. The game's won now. Do you swap them round and give others a chance? I think maybe he might do that. But I think if you were Beckford, you wouldn't want to come off, because you could see more goals for himself.
There speaks a goal scorer. We've had 6 goals in the first half. There could be more to come, probably will be more to come in the second half at the Diva Stadium. Chester 1, Leeds United 5. Premier League is off and underway big time on Saturday. Arsenal against West Bromwich Albion, 12:30, Sky Sports 1 and HD1. And on Sunday, double bill, Chelsea against Portsmouth from 1 o'clock and Manchester United against Newcastle, 3:30, both Sky Sports 1 and HD1. It's Chester 1, Leeds 5 at the Diva, and elsewhere it looks like this. I'll just pick out one or two which look like potentially being shocks. Bournemouth 1, Cardiff 2 though. Paul Parry's got both the goals there. Brighton 4-0 up against Barnet. Adam Virgo's got a couple. Bristol City 0, Peterborough 1. George Boyd, the goal scorer there. Charlton 0, Yeovil 1. Paul Warne, the goal scorer. Potential shock there. Crewe 2, Barnsley 0. Michael O'Connor, a penalty. And Anthony Elding, also a penalty. Crystal Palace 0, Hereford 1. Moses Ashokodi, 8 o'clock kickoff there. And Grimsby 1, Tranmere 0. James Hunt, the goal scorer. Leicester leading Stockport 1-0. Luton 1 up against Plymouth, Rossi Jarvis. Macclesfield 1 up against Blackpool, Sean Brisley. And Milton Keynes Dons 1-0. Sam Baldock, the goal scorer. Sheffield Wednesday 1-1. Swindon 2-1 up against Queen's Park Rangers, Simon Cox and Billy Painter. Walsall 1-1 with Darlington. Michael Ricketts has scored and been sent off for Walsall. And Wolves a goal down to a Paul Mullen goal against Accrington Stanley. Ready at the Diva Stadium. It's Chester 1, Leeds United 5. Commentators Gary Birtles and Rob Hawthorne.
Well, how did Chester come back from this? They've made 2 changes. They're investing in youth with 20-year-old Jay Harris and 19-year-old Sean Kelly coming on. And off have gone Richie Partridge and Paul Butler. A disappointing night for him against his old club as Chester reshape for the second half. And really it is just a question of limiting the damage now, having shipped in 6 goals at Dagenham at the weekend, to have let in 5 in the first half here now. Simon Davis must, in his own mind, be already preparing for a weekend league match. So young Sean Kelly on, hoping to tighten up that back line. A touch there for Kelly, looking for Ellison. It's away by Rui Marquez. Here's Fraser Richardson. Now Linwood. Now Mannix. Marquez letting it run.
Simon Davis, what he'll be looking for second half? Is there any positives he can take out of the game? He'll be looking for a 0-0 second half. As you say, damage limitation. And Cam McAllister's kept the same players out there, so obviously he wants them to stretch the lead even more.
Well, this is Chester's 5th year back in the Football League now. They got promoted into the league in the same year that Leeds were relegated from the Premier League. In all 4 seasons since they got back into league football, Chester have been knocked out of this competition at this stage. It's rare for them to score in the competition. Tonight is the first goal they've scored in the League Cup since they got back into the league, since they got one against Wolves, and that was in a 5-1 defeat. It was 3 years ago. There's Mazika. Now Wilson. There's Lowe, who got their goal tonight via a deflection from Marquez. He was looking to slip Ellison through there, but Huntington cut it out. There's Kelly. And Barry, Mannix, this is Lowe, Harris has moved on to it, Richardson. stop grass. Good block.
And again, a very incisive move. Moved the ball very quickly. Grass worked the opening, but a decent block. There's Mazika. Now Barry. Here's Horn. And this is Lowe. Anthony Barry's ball in, cut out by Marquez. Now Becchio. Tripped by Mazika.
He's got to be careful. Mazika, hooked already.
Here's Richardson.
Mischief.
Look at the first half, 5-1. And Danby, the keeper, only made one save. Pretty back of the net five times, but just made one save. The most overworked keeper in the Football League at the moment, John Danby, in terms of picking the ball out of the back of the net. But he is the only goalkeeper, senior goalkeeper, on the books of Simon Davis. And squad strength very much the problem for the Chester manager. There's a pool of about 20 players. A couple of those have been linked with moves elsewhere. Paul Rutherford and Mark Hughes, who aren't part of the squad on duty tonight. The Leeds are about to enter the fray in terms of substitutions now. In a position of some comfort in this tie. Sheehan's made decent progress. He's looking for Beckford from his cross.
And Sheehan's been ever so well down the left-hand side there. He passed two challenges. Still managed to wrap his leg round the ball and put the ball to the far post.
Here's Snodgrass with the corner. Danby stretching. Triple substitution here for Leeds United. Jonathan Douglas, Bradley Johnson, not sure when we're all coming on for them here. Douglas, the former Leeds captain, replacing Johnny Howson. Douglas, the Republic of Ireland international, has been linked recently with a move into the Championship with Burnley. Bradley Johnson makes his first appearance since the playoff final. A back injury ruled him out at the weekend. Place of Andrew Robinson, who goes off having scored his first goal for Leeds. But his goal and the first goal for Leeds of Robert Snodgrass, really the interlude for the scoring performance of the night. But there'll be no addition to it for Jermaine Beckford. It will stop at the hat-trick as he goes off in the third substitution made here by Gary McAllister. Really has been his night.
Strange time for the substitutions, isn't it? You thought, well, half time, 7 minutes later. Three are made.
Straight down to get ready for the weekend as Shawumi comes on and Beckford goes off to public acclaim.
That's a good, a bit of respite. Three have gone off. Beckford, Robinson's gone off. Shawumi, he's come on. Douglas has come on, Johnson's come on. No respite at all.
Here's Becchio, looking to slip Shawumi in. Like Beckford, actually, he opened his account for the season at the weekend. Johnson straight into the action, finds Sheehan. Now Fabian Delph, who's impressed on what's only his fourth senior appearance for Leeds. Richardson, now Shawumi. Douglas available. Can't reach him though. That's out by Linwood. There's Barry. Now Mazika. Anthony Barry. And the header back by Richardson. Douglas. There's Richardson. There may have been a temptation from Leeds to prioritise this season, promotion being so important to them. Gary McAllister keen to progress in a competition where the leading lights enter later on, in the case of the teams in Europe, in the third round.
It's really good that he's got at his disposal a very deep squad. No Prutton tonight, no Andy Hughes. Just seen the three lads who've come on, so it's good for Gary McAllister that he can just change things around a little bit, give key players a little bit of a rest.
Here's Huntington, now Douglas. Fisher would me Holmes header, now Linwood. Mazika. Huntington, and now Rui Marquez. Leeds have never lost a first round tie in this competition. Normally they've entered at a later stage of it. Comfortably in control here, thanks to that first half display in which Beckford got his hat-trick. Looking to resume normal service again here now with Johnson looking for Shawunmi. And it's Linwood who gets it away.
Oh, this time Johnson does exceptionally well. Ball pinged from fully 60 yards, took it in his stride, still managed to hook it across the face of the goal.
Free kick to Leeds. And this is another opportunity, particularly from the weekend, to expose the frailties of Chester.
Mazika again committed the foul. He's committed three or four second half and he's got to be really careful. Referee is letting him off a little bit.
Steve Price with the delivery, looking for Becchio with a loop header. And Danby got an important touch.
Not a bad attempt from distance with his head there, slightly behind him. A decent ball whipped in. You see how far he is out, slightly behind, still generates the power. His fingertips have to come in.
Luciano Becchio, who started at Boca Juniors, he had non-playing spells in Barcelona and Mallorca, heading in the area again. Cleared by Ryan Lowe.
Simon Davies will have said to his player, just cut out the mistakes, don't take any chances, don't get caught in possession. Because if you do, you've seen this quality lead side will punish you.
Here's Marquez. Now Douglas. Richardson. Paul Huntington. Delf.
He's having the ball at his feet, isn't he, Delf? Drops a little bit deeper. Sometimes he doesn't need to. He'll go a little bit further forward and commit the three midfielders who are patrolling the halfway line.
Huntington. Here's Johnson. Becchio giving it back to Bradley Johnson, or aiming to. Harris cut it out. Is it anywhere will do for a Chester defence under pressure at the moment?
That's what they should have done a couple of times first. Nice learning curve, isn't it?
Well, a team constructed mainly around local-born players, a lot of players from Liverpool, some have come back here, having played elsewhere. Here's Richardson. Nash Woodley. Now Snodgrass. Decent ball in, and he was well worth a goal on his performance tonight, but Delph couldn't get it then.
Just ghosted in, didn't he? Well, played into Shawumney. He held it up well. Snodgrass gets it wide, puts a decent ball in, where he is, time and space. Just couldn't direct it on target. Give the lad credit for getting in. Just seeing him picking it up just in and around the halfway line, but he's not frightened to get in there.
Summer, Fabian Delph, he was playing for the England under-19s at the UEFA Championships in the Czech Republic last month. And the failure to cut it out by Kelly has let Shawumney in here. And Danby saves.
Well, Becchio must wonder if he's not wearing the right aftershave on, he's got an antiperspirant on, because nobody will pass it to him when he's in cracking areas. The number of times he's been in the centre of goal and would have been a tap-in, just hasn't been delivered his way.
Delph, Douglas, here's Huntington. Shawumney. Well, the Chester are under siege is very much underlined by the possession that Gary McAllister's team have enjoyed. Here's Barry. Vaughan. And Zika. This is Wilson. Richardson covering against Ellison. Leeds had that points deduction to overcome last season, and at the moment, the way things have started in the league for them, Chester will be grateful. Three teams in their division are starting minus points. Luton and Rotherham and Bournemouth. That's kept them off the bottom of the table as things stand, as early as it is in the season to be talking about tables. Zika. It's Harris looking to spread it, aiming for Ellison. Took it down well, and Richardson closed him down equally well.
He certainly did. And you see the desire there. Another 5-1 up. I don't want to concede another. You know what? Chester surprised me. I thought they'd really sink a little bit low, shrug their shoulders and heads had dropped, but they haven't. They're a young, enthusiastic side. A bit of a confidence boost.
He's been given away by Kelly, and he could be in trouble here. If Shawumney can get a run on goal, Enoch Shawumney blazes it wide.
Well, there we see the difference. Beckford in the first half, three absolute beauties. Shawumney does everything right. Give the ball away again, though. Chester didn't need to do that. Then he slips. There's the power, acceleration. Just when you need the composure, nowhere to be seen. Not even close.
Mazika. Alex. Linwood. Here's Jonathan Douglas. Now Shear. Johnson. break down the left. Here's Sheehan. Barrett. Here's Mannix. Lowe's pulled out wide. This is Harris. Lowe wide of him. Now Ryan Lowe.
Still trying to pass it. They're still trying to do the right things.
Crunching in with a challenge on Harris, and Ryan Lowe not particularly happy about it, but should be left to the referee to deal with it as he sees fit, and got a card in his hand here to sort the situation out.
Rightly so, that was ridiculous from Delph. He's been passive all the game, he's been terrific on the ball. What was he thinking about doing that? It's just totally ridiculous. No need, no provocation. He's just gone and scissor-kicked his player, wrapped his legs around him, and then was surprised at the reaction from his opponent. Had he reacted?
A little bit of youthful impetuosity from Fabian Delph. One blemish on an otherwise tremendous performance from the youngster. He's given away a free kick. Swept in towards Alisson! A really brave dive for it.
Well,
lost his trousers in the process, lost his shorts in the process.
Round the houses have come down, oh dear. What a ball in this is, though. Good movement. Nobody deals with it, and he's dived at the near post, and oh, that's eluded everybody. Brave dive, and just scrapes the outside of the post there.
Wouldn't be away.
Got good vision, Delph. Applauded by Shawumni, rightly so. It's nice to see a young player with a range of passing. Take it short, try it long.
So, clash of heads. And the two parties involved.
But a delayed reaction. Both go honestly. There. Forehead to the back. Still going on.
A bit of afters that the referee is keen to bring a halt to.
Wasn't meant, it's just a challenge that happens on a football pitch. You go to head the ball, referee, a little bit of a shove in the back there, good for you.
Ball in, looking for Alisson again, getting into the right areas. But without the desired result so far for Chester.
Mistake they've made this second half, they nearly got punished for, and Shawumni went through. Apart from that, cleared the lines, not taken any chances, and restricted Leeds a little bit more than it did first half.
A lot of speculation about what Simon Davis's half-time team talk may have been constructed around, and surely respectability was part of that. Snodgrass's ball in, Danby holds on to that.
Just have to do the basics right, and in the first half they didn't do that. You don't do that right, you get punished. In this second half, it's been a little bit better. When they have been in trouble, they've cleared the lines. They haven't tried to play it out and be clever.
Keep a low. Booted clear by Huntington. Here's Becchio. Mannix.
I feel sorry for him. He's been like the invisible man out there, hasn't he? He's been getting good positions and nobody will pass it to him.
He's aimed for Ellison. was beaten to by Rui Marquez. Here's Snodgrass. Now Mannix. Wilson. Let's get clear by Rui Marquez. Wilson. Carries ball to Vaughan. Now Mozica. Won by Delph. Here's Shawunmi with only Becchio up ahead. He's tried to play him in this time, but he's offside.
Yeah, could have been laid in a little bit earlier, maybe. Trying to hold his run. See there, could have been played there. Just holds on too long. Should have been played earlier. Couldn't stay onside in the end. The opportunity to be laid to him. Tried his best, but Shawunmi, unfortunately, held on too long.
Leeds scored six in their record victory in this competition. There was a hat-trick in that one too from Robbie Keane against Leicester, but they're struggling to find their sixth goal here. Everything they touched, particularly Jermaine Beckford touched, turned to gold in that first half. But Danby proving harder to beat in the second half. And Beckford now just a spectator.
The headphones on.
Here's Lowe. Deflected through, which took some of the sting out of it.
Problem when Beckford isn't on the pitch, you miss as a midfield player his movement. He's easy to find.
Here's Rui Marquez. Douglas. Trying to keep it in with his hand. Here's Sheehan. Now Shawunmi. Now Delph. Here's Marquez. Richardson. Shawunmi's offside.
Well, he shouldn't have been. You can see right across the pitch there. He's wagging the finger. He's got to be right if he's wagging the finger. Well, look where he's standing. How tough is that, to be fair? He can see right the way across. He is offside. Wag your finger all you like.
Snodgrass away here. Snodgrass and Andy Robertson, the support acts to Jermaine Beckford with Leeds goals tonight. And Lowe has got one for Chester, showing interest again there. Past Linwood, here's Shawunmi. He's got Kelly to shrug off. He dived in with a tackle, but he didn't get a bit of the ball.
The referee was miles away from it. The assistant was closer. And we see the power. Pace gets him away again, gets in the box. There's the challenge. It isn't a foul.
It was a risky one from Kelly.
It certainly was. The assistant was right up with it.
Shear. Becchio. He's looking for room for Douglas. Cleared by Vaughan.
Just being professional now, aren't they, Leeds? Seeing the game out.
issue with me.
Needs to hit the target and be ready for it.
Wilson. Now Mozica. That's Ellison. Head back into the path of Mozica. Can he mark his home debut with a goal here? Well, Ellison thought he'd put it in. There's a man on the line, but the referee has pointed to the spot.
He certainly pushed it. Chester fans screaming for the red card to come out. That'll happen.
Richardson complaining. Huntington is joining in the argument as well. He is reaching for a card here. It's a yellow.
He's not convinced he's fouled him even. Mozica does well, gets in the box. Ankergren comes bursting out. It's a great deal in that. The referee was behind the play. It was difficult to see exactly what happened from his position.
Well, he scored one already, Ryan Lowe. And here's his chance for a second for Chester City up against Kasper Ankergren. Scores.
Cool as you like. Ankergren was trying to put him off, moving all over the place. Just kept his head down, made his mind up. Look, you see Ankergren trying to kid him. Sends him the wrong way, bottom corner. Textbook penalty.
Completely unfazed by the goalkeeper's fidgeting. Ryan Lowe gets his second of the night. And it gives the score a healthier complexion from the home team's point of view. It is perhaps a testament to their improvement in the second half.
Definitely, I think Simon Davis will be a lot happier with what he's seen out there. The team haven't taken chances, as we said before. The one they did, they nearly got punished. They've kept up the work rate, made it difficult for Leeds, who, you have to say, have taken three key players off and slowed it down. But as the home side, after the defeat on Saturday and going 5-1 down, give them credit, kept at the task.
Well, that's a bit short. Johnson could very nearly have made Vaughan pay there.
When they take a little bit of a chance, puts them under pressure. Decent ball, doesn't know what to do with it, just sits up a little bit. Vaughan saying he didn't kick it.
Free kick. Mozica, who won the penalty award out of Graham Salisbury.
Well, see Mozica burst onto it. There's the referee's position. Richardson comes behind. Yeah, there's an arm in the back. Not a big arm in the back, but maybe enough to send him over Ankergren. So he did have a decent view of it from there and just judged that there was a little nudge there, enough to put Mozica off.
Maddox. Douglas looking for Shawunmi here. Dambi has come a very long way and he's completely caught out by that. Nobody in the middle for Shawunmi. The goalkeeper trying to get himself out of an embarrassing situation, and in the end he had to be helped out.
Well, Shawunmi couldn't do anything from there. If he'd have tried to shoot from there, it would have been a miraculous angle to score from. Again, every time they make a little bit of a mistake, they're nearly punished for it. You've got to learn very quickly that can't keep doing that, especially against teams from higher standard of football.
Well, it was the youngster Sean Kelly then who got his goalkeeper out of those difficulties. There's Sheehan, now Delph. Here's Douglas. Now Richardson. Snodgrass. Becchio. Made though by Kelly. Marquez. Now Huntington. Harris. Huntington. And Sheehan. There's Mannix. Now Vaughan. Mannix again. Harris. Linwood. Ball to Wilson. He's taken in his stride well. He's edged out of it by Douglas. Did well to try and retrieve it, but Douglas clears. Down the line from Snodgrass, who prefers it on his left foot.
Can't be taking no chances.
Not missed a game in his two seasons with the club from Kidderminster, and just as well, bearing in mind the lack of cover that Chester have in that department at the moment. It's a priority for Simon Davies to try and get another goalkeeper in.
He might wish to miss these last two.
Here's Delph. Himself in a tangle there. Shawumbi has a go. Shawumbi just about hanging on.
That's a better effort from Shawumbi. Steadied himself, kept it down on the target.
Well, the chances have still been coming for Leeds in the second half, but they've lacked the quality that Beckford gave them with his finishing in the first half. Gary McAllister, who captained Leeds in the 96 final, the defeat by Villa that really marked the start of the end of Howard Wilkinson's reign. But he also actually scored the first goal in that run to Wembley. And they beat Notts County. Short again, Shawumbi very nearly coming between Kelly and the goalkeeper.
Can't be saved. Thank you very much there. Very kind of you, leaving it short with the gentle giant there bursting through.
Douglas. Cleared by Harris to Lowe. Harris again. And away goes Ellison. He's got Lowe to his left, but he can't get around Rui Marquez. Well, they were looking for a free kick.
I think that's obstruction.
He was aiming to release Shawumbi, but it's wide of him.
Ellison does well here. Burst clear, and that is obstruction. Clear obstruction, the arm goes in, down he goes, and nobody gives it.
There's Mozica. Linwood. Kelly. Vaughan. There's Barry. There's Fraser Richardson with a header back. Richardson. Douglas. Marquez. Sheer. Becchio. Fouled by Johnson, and it's going to be more than just a free kick.
They're the little things that annoy managers. You're 5-2 up, away from home. It's a lunge that's not really needed.
Well, there's the shake of the head. You can't understand it either.
On its own, single yellow doesn't mean much, but you never know. What a costly suspension might be incurred. And that will have been one of the contributing factors. Header clear by Huntington.
That's two on the trot.
Here's Barry. Jay Harris had made the run. It's low. He's tried to take it on. Clearly pulled back Sheehan, though. Well, Wickham next up for Chester, and we'll be seeing their first venture into the Carling Cup tomorrow when they play Birmingham. It's live on Sky Sports 2 and HD 2 from 7 o'clock. Horn. It's Delf. Now Snodgrass. It's Richardson who's made the move to his right. Three in the middle if he can find one of them. Wilson trying to hold him up. And does so, getting the goal kick.
Wilson's been another player who's impressed. He's good going forward. Determination to get back there.
He's at Everton in his youth, Lawrence Wilson.
At the moment, Simon Davies will think, right, we've won the second half 1-0. Yeah.
5 minutes to go. The other question to remain is, can Ryan Lowe emulate Jermaine Beckford and get a hat-trick? Won't be in the same happy circumstances as has happened for Beckford, you would feel, but it will be a personal achievement for him all the same. It's a shoulder of Linwood, but no handball decision given by Graham Salisbury. Now Richardson. Here's Becchio. Now Delf.
Okay. Real ability there, Delf.
Sheehan. Taken down, Leeds with a free kick. Chester with more cause for concern over a second match in a row where they could let in six. And it's Sheehan who's lined up this free kick for Leeds. Headed goalwards by Snodgrass. The referee wants it retaken. There was some encroachment there, which is going to lead to a booking for James Vaughan.
Well, he wasn't happy with the free kick that was given.
Ryan Lowe just seeking an explanation. which is giving Sheehan a little more time to ponder what he does from here. And it's Sheehan who looks to play in Delft this time. It struck against him. It was over elaborate.
Certainly was. A little bit telegraphed. I do like that young man. So confident on the ball, so laid back. He just drifts across the surface. The range of passing he possesses. Good vision. Gary McAllister will be delighted with his performance.
Thank you. Linwood. Here's Mazika. Now Huntington. Johnson. Here's Sheehan. Here's Delph. Becchio's offside.
Again, it's Delph picking the ball up, bursting forward, as he's done on so many occasions. Had it not been for Beckford's hat-trick, his performance would have been a man of the match one.
Leeds heading into tomorrow's second round draw. The first hurdle they've negotiated comfortably enough. The job was pretty much done in the first half by them. Chester have managed to put on a veneer of respectability in the second half. Two added minutes. So still a little bit of time for Ryan Lowe to match Beckford's feet and get his own hat-trick. Being forced wide there by Marquez. Fell short for Barry, who did well to retrieve it. It's Wilson's ball in, cleared by Huntington. Snodgrass with a header away. Just caught Wilson on his way through. Linwood. Low. Anderson held off by Richardson, who wins the throw. In summary, Gary, a comfortable night really in the end for Leeds.
It certainly was. They started the game really professionally. They got a little bit of help from Chester in the first half. See the couple of sloppy goals. Beckford, supreme class, finished three times with unbelievable ability.
Chester looking for more late consolation. Here's Lowe. Richardson doesn't cut it out, and Ellison rattles it into the side netting.
Gone right to the finish, haven't they? Going low does well, he stays onside, he's played on there by Richardson. Decent ball across, Richardson misses it and could not direct it into the open goal. And he knows it was a good chance.
Will be the last act of the game anyway from Ankergren to take the kick. Here's Sheehan. Referee going beyond the allotted time. An outstanding hat-trick from Jermaine Beckford smooths the path into the second round of this competition for Leeds United. Gary McAllister's side there thanks to outstanding examples of quality finishing from the striker. Simon Davis's team may have leaked now 11 goals in two games, but they did add a bit of respectability in that second half with a second goal from Ryan Lowe as they just tried to ease the situation after a turbulent first 45 minutes in which the job was pretty much done by Leeds. It finishes Chester 2, Leeds 5.
Leeds United getting exactly what they wanted out of that game. They kept the momentum going from the weekend when they beat Scunthorpe. And we're also through to round two of the Carling Cup, which will be drawn tomorrow night after we show you Wickham against Birmingham City live in round one of the Carling Cup from 7 o'clock on Sky Sports 2 and HD2. And the Premier League burst into action on Saturday. Arsenal against West Bromwich Albion, 12:30, Sky Sports 1 and HD1. And on Sunday, a double bill, Chelsea against Portsmouth from 1 o'clock and Manchester United against Newcastle from 3:30, both Sky Sports 1 and HD1. Well, Chester can at least say they won the second half. We'll get the views of Ian Rush in a moment or two. But in truth, the game was over at half-time. A Jermaine Beckford hat-trick had put paid to any hopes Chester had of getting anything out of the game at all. It was already 5-1 at half-time. Now, Leeds United can say thank you to their fans and they can be returned the compliment. The 2 Leeds 5. Jermaine Beckford got his first goals in the League Cup and his first ever hat-trick. He's alongside his skipper, Fraser Richardson, both talking to Andy Burton.
Main 4 goals in pre-season, 1 at the weekend, a hat-trick for you tonight. That's been the perfect start to the season, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. Hopefully that all my goals and the hard work for myself and the rest of the boys can kick us through to, you know, hopefully getting the promotion that we wanted.
What's been working for you in the last few weeks? What's clicking?
Just the way everyone gets along.
What are you laughing at?
Pretty much the way everyone gets along. We just seem to rub off on each other, and if one person's happy and one person's really, really confident, it rubs off on the rest of us, and like today's performance showed that.
Fraser, does he do that sort of thing in training?
He tries to. No, he's a different class, you know. He knows where the goal is, you know. He's just turning on a sixpence these days and just shooting from anywhere, and they seem to be going in all over the gaff, so long may it continue, really.
Do you think his goals can send you up this season?
Definitely, you know. It showed last season, you know. Everyone keeps banging on about the minus 15, but Jermaine's goals last season would have taken us up, and hopefully they can produce the same form this season for us.
Is it awkward when you've scored 5 goals in 34 minutes a bit?
No, not really.
It's embarrassing, isn't it?
No, not really. We came in at half-time and the gaffer said, you know, the most embarrassment would be to go out and just, you know, take the mic. But we didn't do that. We went out there and we showed as quality and as passing, and I thought we should have gone on and got a few more, but unfortunately we didn't. I'm quite disappointed to give away the penalty as well, but these things happen.
Well, listen, you're into the next round. That's the most important thing. And Jermaine, you are the Carling man of the match. Fraser, do the honours for us, please.
Well done, man.
Nice one, brother.
Take care.
Cheers.
There you go. Well done.
Thanks, boys.
Perfect night for Leeds United, eh, Ian?
Yeah, they got what they came for. They played the stronger side, got 5 goals up, and second half they took the main players off. But, you know, they got out of the game what they wanted to.
For Chester City, I mean, to win the second half, to get a goal back there, and can they take all these positives out of the situation?
They have to, because in League Two, they won't be coming up with against teams as good as Leeds. I think the second half, you know, Chester, they created a couple of chances as well, and the team that Leeds played the second half would be easily good enough in League Two. And I think Chester got to take the positives out of that and say, listen, we're not going to be up against these quality players every week. Learn from our mistakes and go into the game on Saturday with confidence. And that's what you need. It's all about confidence at that level as well. And I think they can do that.
Jermaine Beckford had a great game, but he looked an even better player when he was off the field, didn't he?
Yeah, I think it was all...
they couldn't score without him, could they?
No, I think it's all about not just the goals he scored, because he took his goals absolutely fantastic there, but I think it was all about his movement off the ball as well. His movement was fantastic. But, you know, when you look at that, you know, he used his strength and he didn't try to blast the ball in that case. And I thought he was excellent. And just his little movement there. And you get a bit of luck sometimes because, you know, miscontrolled it there. But there's no luck about this one. We knew what he meant. And he's absolutely pure quality. That's with his left foot as well, isn't he?
He was League One Player of the Year last season. He's working under Gary McAllister and Steve Staunton. Can he go all the way in the game, do you think?
Well, they're under the right people if they're going to do that. You know, we see with his quality, with his goals there, you know, especially the last one, like this one there, it was absolute quality. But I think Gary McAllister and Steve Stone will be looking to get more out of him, to make him a better player to reach the Premiership. And say they'll have a good chance with them two in charge. But that is pure quality. You can't teach that. That chippy done there, that was pure quality.
And you can only score goals against the team that's in front of you, can't you?
Exactly, yeah. You know, he scored three goals in 45 minutes, and he came on for 6 minutes second half, and I think he was right then just to get the applause of when he went off the pitch.
Yeah, I think that was deliberate, wasn't it? Just 6 minutes and you can go off and get some deserved applause.
Well, that's what it's all about. He deserved, and that's what he deserves.
Yeah. Let's hear from Gary McAllister. He must be delighted by the whole evening. Picked a strong team, got the right result, and keeps it all going forward for Leeds United. He's with Andy Burton now.
Was that your best performance from your team as a Leeds manager?
No, I felt at times we've played some good stuff. You know, building up to the playoffs last year, we played some good football at times. But I think tonight was just purely about getting through the tie, getting through into the next round. And I think we showed that we were serious coming here. We played a strong side. We gave Chester a lot of respect. We knew they would have a reaction after losing heavily at the weekend. And all credit to them, they kept going in the second half when it had been quite easy just to throw the towel in. So credit to them for keeping going in the second half.
I know you're a humble guy. Is it a bit awkward when you're that many goals ahead after such a short space of time? You almost not know where to look.
No, at times, you know, we did make it look quite easy, but, you know, we worked hard to get the space, and some of the passing and some of the movement was excellent, and it's hard to defend against that. So very pleased. You know, we scored some good goals and created a lot of chances. You know, we're happy to be in the next round.
Jermaine Beckford got his first senior hat-trick today. What tribute would you pay to his performance?
I thought the three different types of finishes, and they were, you know, fantastic. You know, the chip was cheeky. You know, the first goal was very opportunist. You know, he looked sharp. He's looked sharp all pre-season. And then he looked sharp at the weekend at Scunthorpe. So we want it to continue.
In some ways, you want to get past the transfer deadline as well, because if he keeps playing like that, other clubs will look at him, you know.
I've been assured by the chairman and everybody at the club he's not gone anywhere, he's not for sale.
You enter the next round, 12 Premier League clubs come in at the second round stage. Do you want one of them? Do you want to be the underdog?
Well, we'd like a nice tie at Elland Road. You know, it's been a while since some of the big boys have been there, so that's why we paid a lot of attention to this game tonight.
And if you keep playing like this, promotion, I guess, is something that people will start talking about early. They already are.
Yeah, we're only one game in the league. There's a long way to go. It's a tough league to get out of, you know, and we've started well, but there's still miles and miles to go.
OK, thanks a lot, Gary.
Cheers.
I think Ken Bates would certainly like a Premier League club in the next round, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
For finances.
Well, that's what it's all about, and that's what Gary said. You know, he played the strongest team because he wanted to get through and get a big-name club, because that's what Leeds United deserves.
We've seen Jermaine Beckford's hat-trick, the other goals now. Robert Snodgrass, he's come down from Scotland with a big reputation up in Scotland, maybe not so much heard down here, but what did you make of him?
Well, I think his movements as well was very good. You know, there's a bad cross there by there, but it's quick on how quick they were on the break here, and good interplay by all the players there, and he just gets in there first, and again, he hasn't blasted it, he just placed it in the corner, and the keeper had no chance.
Ryan Lowe did get one back in the first half for Chester to make it 1-2 on the night, and that gave them a bit of hope, didn't it?
Yeah, because at one stage you think, say, Leeds are going to run riot, and I think when they got this goal, it gave the supporters and the players a bit of hope, because it was a bit of luck, but it's what Chester needed. But for 10 minutes after that, Chester looked really, you know, well organised and looked like they might get back into the game.
Sandwiched between two more Jermaine Beckford goals is an Andy Robinson goal, and he's had a big influence so far coming into Leeds, hasn't he, from Swansea?
Yeah, I think, he's got a great left foot on him, and he was one of the best players in that league last season for Swansea, and, you know, he's got a great left foot. We know what he can do. He's managed it that with his right foot, but it's again, he hasn't blasted it. He just side-footed it there and just took the keeper the wrong way.
Second half, the only goal came from Chester, a penalty. Was that a bit of sympathy by the referee, or was it, do you think, a reasonable penalty?
You're looking from where the referee's position was. I didn't think it was a penalty here, but looking from the referee's position later on, and he has put his arm across that, and so the referee was right to give a penalty. He's come across them from the referees there. It was a penalty, and Ryan Lowe done really well to put it away.
Arm out there, wasn't it? And Ryan Lowe's second goal of the game, so he's got two anyway. So
It's always nice as you strike, you know, no matter if you lose, it's always nice to get off and running, and for Ryan to do that would be good for his confidence.
11 goals conceded in two games in 4 days. Can they go forward from this at all, do you think?
Yeah, they have to. I think you've got to put that behind you. You're playing a quality team in Leeds, so I think it's just first game of the season, and take a lot of the positives out of the game and say, go to the next game and say, we can win the game. It's at home, and say, listen, after that second half performance, no, we can do something.
OK, let's hear what Simon Davis thinks. He's with Andy Burton now.
Simon, how do you sum up what you've seen out there tonight?
Well, the first half, I thought it was going to be a long, long night. We've started off and we've got done by the one ball, and you know, after the weekend where we conceded a few, you're thinking, you know, it's going to be a long one again. But to be fair, we've got the ball down and played, and I thought, you know, we've actually come out of it with a bit of credibility there at the end, so that, you know, we've actually worked hard and the lads have done themselves proud, and the second half performance especially, you know, we've stuck to our guns. It could have, you know, we're in there and it's 5-1, and you think, you know, where we're going to go from here, sort of thing. And I just said to him, go out and do yourselves justice in terms of sticking together as a team. You know, we win, lose, draw as a team. And they went out there, and you know, I thought we just shaded the second half, and we got a goal there to help us out. But like I say, when you've got quality, you know, in a side like that, and the lad up top for them, he's I was behind one of his goals, and you're thinking it's the only thing he's got on, and he's just put it in the top bin, and it's a sublime chip, and you just think, well, you can't do anything about that.
I can't imagine a dressing room like that when you've conceded five at half-time is a good place to be. There are reports and murmurings down here that there was arguments in the dressing room, maybe even a fracas involving some of the players. Can you clear that up? What happened in there at half-time?
No, there's nothing much went on. It was just a few indifferences and people just caring about the first half performance. Nothing much, handbags.
And for you as manager, you battle on here and you just try and get through it and pick them up, is that right?
Yeah, of course. And you know, we've got Wickham at home on Saturday, but like I say, I take an awful lot of encouragement out of the team's display. I mean, again, you know, we didn't defend too well, but then, you know, three of the goals were magnificent for them tonight, and we won't be playing against that week in, week out. So every little thing we're getting done for at the moment. So, you know, I took a lot of positives out of that, and, you know, I'm proud of the lads second half.
Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
Here's the rest of the scores, and let's look down for any shocks down there. We'll Bristol City did beat Peterborough in the end, a late goal by Steve Brooker. Charlton have lost at home to Yeovil. Paul Warren, the hero there for Yeovil. Crystal Palace beating Hereford in the end. Derby's gone to extra time. Nathan Ellington has made it 2-1 in extra time for them. Grimsby from League Two have beaten Tranmere of League One 2-0. Luton are the shock there on that page. Luton 2, Plymouth 0. Jarmison Plummer, the goal scorer there for the League Two team. Macclesfield have beaten Blackpool by 2-0. Again, League Two beating a Championship club there. Milton Keynes 1-0 against Norwich. Sam Borlock, the goal scorer. Sheffield Wednesday and Rotherham have gone to extra time. Swansea beating Brentford by 2-0. Swindon have gone down to Queen's Park Rangers 3-2 in the end. Watford 1, Bristol Rovers 0, Will Hoskins' late goal. And Wolves 1, Accrington 1's gone to extra time. Chris Iwolumo, after 73 minutes, has equalised the Paul Mullen goal at Molineux. So there we are, Leeds United going through to round two. The draw is tomorrow night after our game between Wickham and Birmingham City. So join us then. And a big thank you to Ian Rush. Thanks a lot, Ian. Really enjoyed your company. Coming up for you on Sky Sports then. It is Wickham against Birmingham City in the Carling Cup tomorrow, 7 o'clock, Sky Sports 2 and HD2. And the Premier League is back on Saturday. Arsenal against West Bromwich Albion, 12:30 on Saturday. And on Sunday, it's Chelsea against Portsmouth at 1 o'clock. And Manchester United against Newcastle, 3:30. All those games on Sky Sports 1 and HD1. It may have been a mismatch, but Leeds pack a punch. From all of us, bye for now. I need some protection, someone to show me the way, someone who deserves it, I want them to stay, to stick with me eternally, and never be weak, and not disappear, after a couple of weeks, ooh, it gets hotter.
Sport news and views at skysports.com.